Hey guys, Stu Hill here with CHEM Digital. I'm going to give you a run through of our latest template. This is in the style of the compass.com real estate website. This is an Elementor page builder template with IDX or Elementor IDX. When you're developing a WordPress website for your real estate business, you don't need to purchase a theme. There is a couple of different editors out there, Elementor being our favorite and one of the leading page builders available. You've got Divi, you've got WP Bakery, to name a couple, but by far I think Elementor is the superior. With every real estate website that we develop, we include a subscription to the Elementor Pro builder that gives a little extra functionality. But in reality, it's very easy to build an IDX real estate website on WordPress using just Elementor. We do have a free Elementor IDX theme that you can download from our website as well. I'll pop the link for that in the description for this video. But let's dive in and take a look at this latest template that we've developed for WordPress that works with IDX. That IDX could be either Showcase or iHomeFinder. In this case, it is iHomeFinder or IDX Broker. Or even diverse solutions. Our favorite IDX provider is iHomeFinder for some of the aesthetics and functionality that is included with that, that gives us some very modern and very intuitive lead capture mechanisms that are really at the cutting edge of design and functionality. So let's dive in. We're here on the homepage of memphisbuyandsell.com. This is the first version of this template that we have developed for a client in the Memphis, Tennessee area. On the homepage, we start with the home search. Obviously, the search box in the middle, picture in the background, very similar to compass.com. Take a look here. We've kind of followed the same design trends, so recommended listings, some neighborhoods, and another search functionality. So again, if we pop back to our Elementor IDX template here, you can modify any of these sections. Obviously the menu, that's you can change the names or what have you very easily, your logo up here, and the search box in the middle. This will do either a city such as Memphis, or it will search through the addresses of specific listings as well. Alternatively, you can put in a zip code and it'll find the zip code. So intelligent universal search bar there. As you scroll down, we've got a gallery of properties. We've loaded four at a time that just scroll through, and you can customize within iHomeFinder or whatever IDX provider you're using the parameters for this search, whether it's like, you know, new listings within the last 7-14 days, or certain price points, and you can have multiple different sections here. You could duplicate this out to include perhaps something like luxury properties or waterfront properties. We'll dive down into that in a second. We build out some neighborhood pages. We've got 9 neighborhood pages here for each of the area that this particular client serves. A search by property type. So this breaks down gated communities, waterfront homes. Now you could, as I mentioned, you could take this section and you could put gated communities, waterfront homes, and you could even include listings for each of those as an idea there, so that, you know, people aren't having to, that you could put a Seymour perhaps, but just so that they can easily dive into the categories. And then finally, as you get to the bottom of the page, we have a Zillow import tool that pulls your reviews automatically from Zillow. So, you know, from now on, just send your clients to Zillow, have them put the reviews on there. It adds a little bit of cachet to the to the review itself when it's hosted on a third-party site rather than just plugging in testimonials that you may or may not have created yourself or modified. So the validity there with the username and the dates that they're posted. You can select even whether you just want five-star reviews. Presumably you only have five-star reviews, that way you can sort by the date or randomize them, whatever the situation might be there. And then as you get down to the footer of the website, you obviously your licensing information and what have you, easy to update. As we go into each one of these pages, the Germantown, let's say for example, this text that drops down to the very bottom, it'll be underneath the search box. So this search is modified to hold the appearance of Zillow or Redfin, Realtor.com. So the header will slide up. Obviously, there's some calls to action here, such as the listing report, sign up, or the ability to switch between open homes, market reports, or just the active listings themselves. In some markets, you have sold properties as well. Just that depends on your IDX provider, your MLS board, and whether they allow you to display sold listings and for how long. As you scroll down, the header disappears, and although I'm logged in, so I've got this black bar at the top, you'll see that the search parameters and filters, that settles at the top of the page for the user. So now when they're scrolling, it just shows the listings as you move up and down. And on the map here, you can see that number two, number whatever, as you hold over these, you can see exactly these two listings are right there. You can see where they are on the map, or the user can see where they are on the map. And that makes it nice and easy. Some of the lead capture mechanism here, so to save the property, they have to put their information in order to create a property organizer account. Now, as you delve into a listing, so let's take this one here, you'll notice that if you go to realtor.com or even redfin.com, and I'm going to start with, let's just do Memphis, Tennessee here, and we'll take this listing, and then we'll go do the same thing here on Redfin. It was Memphis, Tennessee. Right, I'll do a quick search there. You'll see that on redfin.com, our search is pretty much identical to what you've got there on Redfin, with the search for the price and etc. This is a gallery view that they use on realtor.com. But as you get into the property details, so we'll select a property on each one of these. And then we'll compare this now to our Elementor IDX template. You've got address and what have you, price, share to social media, save to a property organizer, print it in a PDF format. You can select a date for a tour, or you can ask a question or for more information about the property. Again, comparing this to realtor.com, you schedule a tour, your share buttons and save, and likewise on Redfin, schedule a tour. So the look and feel of this is very familiar to many users, and that'll reduce the bounce rate. So one of the big things is when anybody comes to your website, you want to give them all the reasons to stay there rather than go to Zillow as a more familiar place to be. Because we've taken these portals portals or large real estate companies as a benchmark, where they're getting thousands to tens of thousands of visitors a day or month. Having a user experience that is benchmarked to these is paramount in order to keep them on your website. So nice and easy here with the property details. As we're in this page, as you scroll down to the bottom, we have included a bunch of search engine optimization text here. So there's lots of links to the schools, the city amenities, and so forth. This just adds to the content of the page. So because the listings have all of the information about school district, and let's just run through a listing page actually. Again, a pop-up here for lead capture. You can set that to demand it. So this is, you can skip past it the way that this website is set up for demonstration purposes. But I would strongly recommend just demanding that they sign up for after either the first search would be my preference, or you can let them look at a couple of properties and then ask them to sign up. Suggestions for similar listings, those pull automatically, mortgage calculator, schools from greatschools.net, it's org now, isn't it? So all of the schools listed here related to that property. Walk score is handy, just as a little bit of extra flash there, but nice clean look and feel to this, again printable for whomever to take a copy with them. So that is a listing page as we rock through here. On the sell side of things, now one of the things that Redfin or Compass doesn't have is an automated home valuation. So how much is your home worth? This actually works nationwide. So if you've got somebody relocating in, they can put their address in anywhere in the country, and it pops up here. It'll ask them for their email and phone number in order to get the valuation on their property. We split out community pages, so typically we will develop 6 inclusive with a template development. We've expanded to 9 in the case of this particular client. However, this directs you to the specific search with SEO text and keywords embedded into the page, and again here straight into the Germantown listings. They can modify the search up here or pull open homes, let's say in Germantown. So that's a simple option for them. And again, on the open homes report here, this is more in the style of Realtor.com. So we've got a nice little blend there between all of the big boys. As we power through here, the blog being your primary place for content for search engine optimization, you're not going to see in a lot of cases, other than brand searches, your main website page coming up as as one of the listings for homes for sale in Memphis. However, a lot of the content in your blog, we'll take the Memphis one here as an example. We got all these pop-ups promoting somebody to sign up. You can change the settings on that to be heavier or lighter, or even turn it off. Although I wouldn't suggest that, since your investment in your website is really all about generating leads. We're here on the Memphis page. This is some SEO content that we've written. And as you start with that general search for Memphis, dropping down and then kind of drilling down that vertical into downtown Memphis, midtown Memphis, east Memphis, these are all areas that you can expand on. So you take that primary keyword, which should be more of a topic, so Memphis real estate, and then all of the subtopics within Memphis real estate in a hierarchy, and just kind of flow out from or fork out from that point. And then, of course, at the bottom of any good blog post on your real estate website, you want to incorporate some listings. That's easily done. You just use a short code that you plug into the Elementor for the IDX that will give you drop the listings gallery in the bottom of the page. Again, just another lead capture mechanism for the site. Bam, here we go again with the register. So push on the registration, about page, self-explanatory, contact page, just modify your information in there, and a login and register to your IDX control panel for your returning visitors. Now, this that's a wrap-up of the site itself and the functionality of the IDX with the Elementor template. We run a Lightspeed WordPress installation. So Lightspeed is an advanced caching solution for WordPress websites, and that dramatically increases the speed of the site. So Lightspeed is cited to be somewhere up to 300 times faster than a WordPress installation elsewhere. So if you've ever heard that WordPress is slow, it is not. This website in particular scores 100% in terms of page speed, so the load time of the page, 100% in terms of accessibility, as far as the images having alt tags, which enable somebody with a need for either a braille reader or an audio reader, if you know, say they're deaf or blind or some other impairment, it is fully functional and fully compliant with the ADA Act. As far as making your website accessible, we've made all the steps there. Google has rated us 100 out of 100 for that too, and also SEO. We get 100% rating from Google Page Insights on that as well. So 100% across the board on all the scores, all the green lights. So yeah, that gives you the technical foundation for building a strong WordPress IDX real estate website. All you've got to do is customize the template. That is certainly something we can help you with. Hop over to our website, CHEM.digital, request a free consultation. My team will help you put together or customize your template and get you set up. If you have any questions related to IDX, whether it's the free IDX from your MLS board, or whether you're trying to decide whether Showcase IDX or iHome Finder or IDX Broker or Diverse Solutions or Realty NA or any of the others are the best fit for you, this template and any of our other WordPress real estate website templates work with any of the IDX providers. We've been doing this for 20 years now, so we're really good at setting them up, configuring them. We work with all of the providers and know their systems inside and out. So any questions, please don't hesitate to ask. Again, I'm Stu Hill with CHEM Digital. Thanks so much for watching. If you found this video useful, please do like it. And if you want more real estate marketing and technology updates, then please do subscribe to our channel here on YouTube, or sign up for our email list and join the other 110,000 realtors across the US that subscribe to and receive my blog posts on a daily basis. Thanks so much for watching.